Good evening, you're watching 7 at 7, the only news bulletin where we curate the day's top 7 stories for our viewers. These are, all right, our top focus story comes in from Karnataka. As we speak, when the country, the state of Karnataka is in the grips of the COVID crisis, 500 doctors have now threatened to resign from tomorrow. They are demanding that state government should make them permanent, doctors relieve them of contracts. These doctors mainly work in primary health centers in rural sectors and have remained the backbone of the health sector of Karnataka over years. Earlier in June, these doctors met state health minister, raised their demand. Subsequently, the government of Karnataka increased the salary from ₹45,000 to ₹60,000. But they are sticking to their demand of their jobs being regularized.
As of now, there are 507 contract-based doctors who have been working under contract from last 4 to 7 years. We have been repeatedly requesting our government with a plea to regularize that, but we have been continuously and repeatedly neglected. Especially during this pandemic time of COVID-19, we are working with our risking our lives as well as our family lives with no job security as or any other facilities that have been provided to the other regular doctors. So we have reached a stage where we are left with no other choice than giving a mass resignation on July 8th. We request our government to respond to our plea and give us an opportunity to continue our service.
This is not the time that health workers or the doctors to do protests and keep the government under ransom. This is like a blackmailing tricks which is not warranted, and especially from a noble profession of healthcare. This was least expected from the government and the citizens of the state. Through dialogue, anything is possible. Not through confrontation, not through buns. This is not the time to do that.
I want to connect right now to my colleague Naga Arjun, who's joining us with the very latest. You know, Naga, at this juncture, the Karnataka government is basically saying that this is blackmail in the times of the COVID crisis, but the doctors are firm. What are you picking up? Is there any possibility of the current crisis to thaw and these doctors can get back to work?
Well, Preeti, just before I came onto this live meeting ended, the doctors and the health department, there is a good news for these doctors. The government has agreed to regularize their jobs and they have sought some 3 to 4 weeks' time. The health minister met these contract doctors association, gave an assurance that the government will take cognizance of the demand and will make sure that they will be regularized in the coming few weeks. A few rules have to be amended because in 2017, these doctors were not regularized. So finally, the battle has been won by the doctors is what they claim. Not just the salary, but their job security is firm as well. The government has finally agreed to regularize and make them permanent in the next few weeks. The health minister will place the topic in front of the cabinet and the chief minister. Few norms have to be amended. And finally, after that, their contract will be turned into regular permanent employees across Karnataka. These 507 had threatened to resign tomorrow and go on strike, but now that the meeting ended, good news for these doctors.
Well, that is very good news. It's been a campaign for India today right here. And thank you, Naga, for giving us that good news. So it seems that they will get their stipend. Appreciate you joining us. But I just want to now shift focus on the same story as well. Repeatedly, these doctors have been promised, like we said, India Today has taken over their plight as well. Meanwhile, after our campaign to get resident doctors their due, the Karnataka minister, Basavraj Bommai, has assured that the protesting doctors will get their stipend. Resident doctors in Devangre JJM Medical College have been demanding stipend denied to them for the last 16 months. Speaking to India Today, the Home Minister Bommai said the management of the college is duty-bound to give stipend, and Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa has held a meeting and has assured that the doctors get their due. The Karnataka government in 2018 had in fact put a halt to the 50-year-old practice of paying a stipend to resident doctors in JJM Medical College owned by Congress MLAs Shiv Shankarappa. But now, all of this is in the past. These doctors are now going to get their stipend. It seems the government has blinked, has decided to entertain their demand finally, which was just, and it was a campaign here on India Today as well, and these doctors have got their stipend.
The management of the private medical college is duty bound to give stipends. However, in some cases, they have made government to pay, but all other private medical colleges pay their own stipends. It is not a government college. The Honorable CM has conducted one meeting. He has talked to the management. Probably today or tomorrow, we'll settle the issue and we'll see that stipend is paid to the medical students.
All right, so that's good news. It has happened. That stipend, like Nagarjun was just pointing out minutes before we came into this news broadcast, the government has decided that the stipend will be paid to those 500 doctors. With that, I want to shift focus on this big exclusive news report filed by my colleague Manjeet Negi. Well, there is talk and there's clear evidence that there is now actual disengagement in Ladakh, especially with all that surrounds the conflict in Galwan. The Chinese have pulled back. But having said that, the Indian Army and the Indian Air Force is on high alert. All of this being documented in this exclusive report by my colleague Manjeet Negi, who actually went and visited the forward air bases.
That's the sound of a country that doesn't sleep. When day turns to night, there's no downtime here in the combat zone. Because even as China takes the first baby steps to pull back from eastern Ladakh, the Indian Air Force has raised its operational preparedness levels in Ladakh to maximum. And what you're looking at is proof of the red alert. 24/7, non-stop, no compromise. Earlier, we showed you high-tempo Apache attack chopper operations by day. And now, the most feared rotorcraft in the world gets set to prowl in the darkness. Pilots strapped in, these formidable machines are fully equipped for the night hunt. And India Today gets exclusive and complete access.
2 days ago, we showed you the day operation of Indian Air Force near China border. Tonight, we will show you how Indian Air Force works 24/7 to protect our border.
The Apache's night eyes lie in this sensor on the Apache's chin, the pilot's night vision sensor. Along with the day-night target acquisition system, the feed from this sensor goes directly to the pilot through his helmet-mounted system. The Indian Apaches flying in Ladakh are flying with Hellfire precision-guided munitions, rockets, and a devastating 30mm chain gun. But the true brain of the Apache, especially at night, isn't visible in these dark images. Don't be fooled by how innocuous that structure looks as it sits above the Apache's rotor. That's the AN-APG-78 Longbow fire control radar. That little sensor enables target detection while the Apache is behind obstacles like hills and mountains, allowing the helicopter to launch an attack before it is even seen.
The night operations have an inherent element of surprise. The Indian Air Force is fully trained and ready to undertake entire spectrum of operations in any environment with the help of modern platforms and motivated personnel. This airbase is well equipped and ready to undertake and support the operations on both fronts simultaneously.
जिस तरह के हालात अभी बॉर्डर पर बने हुए हैं, हमारा जोश जो है इस समय आसमान से भी ऊंचा है और भारतीय वायुसेना का हर एक वायु योद्धा, हर एक वायुयान पूरी तरह सक्षम है और हम किसी भी परिस्थिति के लिए इससे निपटने के लिए एकदम तैयार हैं।
The lack of light is no hindrance to this beast of a chopper. In fact, it brings its own advantages. But the Ladakh darkness is seeing more than just the Apache flex its muscle on combat patrols. That's the unmistakable double chop of the Chinook. The iconic tandem rotor heavy lift helicopters that are pulling their weight even in the darkness. Chinook pilots in Ladakh are similarly making full use of the helicopter's night vision systems, giving them complete freedom to fly and operate in the combat zone.
Amid the tension with China, Air Force is carrying out whole night operation. Message is loud and clear. We are ready with 24/7.
And away from the war helicopters, Indian Air Force jets like MiG-29s and Su-30s are also keeping the tempo of combat flights uninterrupted. The clock never stops. War readiness is non-negotiable here in Ladakh. With Manjeet Negi in Ladakh, Bureau Report, India Today.
All right, I want to shift focus right now. After curbing work visas, there is now a curb on visas for international students in the United States of America. If you're an Indian student and your classes have moved online in your university, you will now have to come back home because you will not be allowed to stay in the United States of America if you're learning online. This, in turn, has now impacted over 2 lakh students.
Blow for thousands of Indian students in the United States and many others aspiring to study in a prestigious U.S. university. Foreign students who have all their courses moved online by their universities will now have to leave the United States or will be denied entry. Those failing to comply may get deported. Fresh student visa curbs by the Trump government for all foreign students say international students have to take at least some physical classes to stay in the United States. And even at colleges offering hybrid courses this fall, international students will be barred from taking all classes online. More than 2 lakh Indian students were in the United States in 2019, according to an estimate. Indian students, like their global counterparts, now face the bleak prospect of all-round confusion, visa denial, bar on entry, and even deportation in COVID times. Last month, the White House suspended H-1B visas, popular among Indian techies, till December this year, making the U.S. soil less attractive for skilled professionals. Trump's critics were quick to attack the new guidelines. Bernie Sanders, independent candidate for presidential election, said the cruelty of this White House knows no bounds. From battling the pandemic overseas to fear of being deported, getting global education and work experience in the United States seems like a distant dream now. Bureau Report, India Today.
All right, so what we figured is about 2 lakhs Indian students who are now studying in international universities in the United States of America will be impacted. Their student visas would be taken away and they'd be sent back home. We'll keep a keen eye on all developments there. I am sure that the Indian government is going to ask the United States of America to possibly revise its policy. But right now, this is where it stands. With that, I want to shift focus right now to our second last story that we are following on 7 at 7. And this is Sushant Singh Rajput. Well, Sushant Singh Rajput, after he passed away by suicide, his promo of his film Dil Bechara released. It broke the internet. On the sidelines of it, the police is continuing its investigation in the suicide of Sushant Singh Rajput, interviewing Sanjay Leela Bhansali. The details that have come out of this interrogation can be horrifying. Sushant Singh Rajput had pretty much the pick of the lot of Sanjay Leela Bhansali's films, but he could not pick one or opt to act in one because he was bound under contract. Take a look at this.
Million views on YouTube in under an hour and left fans teary-eyed and the industry folks in awe. Anushka Sharma, Rajkumar Rao, Siddharth Malhotra, Vidyut Jamwal, Moni Roy, Ritesh Deshmukh, Pariniti Chopra and many others shared the trailer of Sushant Singh Rajput's film on their respective social media accounts. Casting director turned filmmaker Mukesh Chhabra, who is helming Dil Bechara, shared an emotional note on social media. Sharing his journey of making the film, he wrote that Sushant will live on in him till his last breath. Meanwhile, filmmaker Sanjay Leela Bhansali visited the Bandra police station on Monday afternoon to record his statement in connection with actor Sushant Singh Rajput's death by suicide case. He was spotted at the police station around noon in a blue and white kurta pajama and a mask. Bhansali was at the station for about 3 hours and the cops recorded his statement in connection with some film he had offered to the late actor but didn't materialize.
Sanjay sir.
Bhansali revealed that he had not spoken to Sushant since 2016. And as he was not close to the late actor, Sanjay also said he wasn't aware of his depression. Abhishek Trimukhe, DCP Mumbai Police, confirmed that Bhansali was planning to take the actor in four of his films, including Ram Leela and Bajirao Mastani. But due to unavailability of dates, the film went to other actors. It is believed that Sushant was focused on Yash Raj Films' Pani to be directed by Shekhar Kapoor at that point in time. Trimukhe further informed that the police has taken in custody CCTV recordings of the building where Sushant was staying. However, no CCTVs were installed in Sushant's house. Forensic reports are awaited. Bhansali's visit comes after Sushant's co-star from his last film, Dil Bechara's Sanjana Sanghi, made a fleeting visit to Mumbai from the national capital to speak to the Bandra police last week. Up until now, over 30 people have been questioned over Sushant's sudden demise, including his manager Shruti Modi, press representative Radhika Nehlani, and close friends Riya Chakraborty and Mukesh Chhabra, among others. That's not all. Journalists from leading entertainment websites have also been questioned to probe if someone was deliberately planting blind items against the Kedarnath actor. Meanwhile, a fan of Sushant Singh Rajput named a star after him and registered it with an international star registry. The fan Raksha tweeted the certificate of registration, saying she did it as the actor was an avid stargazer. It was a gesture by Sushant's fan and will not be used for any official purpose. It's no secret that the actor was interested in celestial studies and also owned a telescope. Entertainment Bureau, India Today.
All right, as usual, we will end 7 at 7 with a fact check where we bust certain, which are not facts, untrue, but are masquerading as facts, and you'd possibly see them on social media, on WhatsApp groups. Well, one of the claims masquerading as a fact which is making the rounds is an image of Biotech Bharat vice president actually taking a dose of the COVID vaccine which the company is producing, the Covaxin. Well, the fact check on this is false. The viral image is of a routine procedural blood test being done on the vice president of Bharat Biotech. So false. Let's move on now to our second fact check. There is a claim which has been floating about on the internet. Once again, you might have seen it on Facebook, WhatsApp groups, on social media, of a train which is leaving from India to the border between India and China, laden with military goods en route to the Indo-China border. Fact check on this, false. This video is more than a year old. Our final fact check this evening, French astrologer Nostradamus predicted COVID. Well, this is a claim which is floating about on social media, WhatsApp groups, but this is just a claim masquerading to be a fact. In any of the books written by Nostradamus, there is no mention of COVID. So false again. All right, with that, we end 7 at 7 by wishing Mahendra Singh Dhoni, the legend cricketer, a very happy birthday. Thank you for joining us. We'll, of course, see you tomorrow evening. Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.